All right, so this is gonna sound a cliche to say the least, but it's so true, and it's kind of weird, it's kind of funny, but how to solve problems by asking the right questions. You know, questions are the answers to these problems. It's crazy, and we're gonna talk about how to solve these problems by asking the right questions. What is up, my fellow goal-getter? Welcome back to another video. And if this is your first time here and you want to dominate your life, become a true goal-getter, make sure you hit subscribe, tap the bell notifications. That way you don't miss anything. And get ready, because we're getting started right now. All right, so in my last video, we were discussing the power of questions, and that's what inspired this video. And I kind of wanted to expand on what we talked about in the last video, because there's some things that I left out, and there's 5 problem solving questions that if you ask these when you're faced with a problem, you're gonna get the answer. It may not come right then and there, but you will get the answer by asking these with enough emotional intensity behind them. So I wanted to expand on what we talked about in the last one. And here's a good concept, you know, this story that I shared in the last video. When I was in prison, all right, and when I was 2 years into my 4-year stay. I did over 5 years total in my life, but this particular time I stayed 4 years, and I was 2 years into it. I was in the hole, which is the prison inside of prison, and I was down there for some tattoo violations, no duh. And it's the prison inside of prison. What I mean by that, it's a bad place. It's depressing. You're in an 8x10 cell. It's dirty. It's dark and dim. You have very little, if any, human interaction, and you get 3 showers a week. It sucked. But I was down there, and 2 weeks into it, I was down there for 2 months. 2 weeks into my 2-month stay in the hole, I get called back to the captain's office, and they told me that my sister had passed away from a heroin overdose. So I wasn't expecting my sister to be dead, you know, when I went in there. I thought somebody told on me. Why would I else would I be going to the captain's office, you know? And that hurt, man. That was one of my lowest points ever in my life. I cried my eyes out for the next 3 days. I had them put me in a cell by myself. I didn't want to be with anybody else. And I cried and I prayed. And on that third day, I finally got to say, you know, I'm still here for a reason. I don't know what it is, but what is the next best step that I can take? What can I do to not feel like this anymore, to feel happy? How can I feel happy? Those are the questions that I ask myself. And questions are so powerful, because in the moments of crisis, it depends on the questions that we ask ourselves, because the questions, whatever questions we ask ourselves, our brain is engineered to answer a question. Wouldn't you agree? You see, like, whether you said yes or no, you still answered it. Our brain automatically seeks the answer. And questions control what we focus on. And whatever we focus on controls what we feel. And whatever we feel determines how we perceive our reality, which then determines how we make our decisions and our behaviors. There's a lot that goes into that. So questions are powerful. It's the key root. What do we do all day long? We habitually ask ourselves questions and answer them, whether we are consciously aware of them or not. You know, we habitually ask ourselves disempowering questions, and many of us ask ourselves empowering. Like if something's happened, you say, why can't I do this? That's a disempowering question. Or if you say, why do I always fail when I do this? That's disempowering, because you're asking yourself, why can't I do this? And your brain's focusing on why you can't do it, which will lead you to not being able to do it, because we get what we focus on. So, or if you say, why do I always fail? Your brain's focusing on why you always fail, and you're going to always fail. So you change that up and say, how can I turn this around? How can I get one step closer to my goal? What's the next best thing I can do? How can I feel happy? You see what I'm saying? You get what I'm going here? So in these moments of crisis. So when I was in there, I asked myself those questions, and that literally empowered me to take these next steps, which was I couldn't do much, but my brain figured out a way to make myself feel happy while I was trapped in a hole and was hearing all these voices in my head. Not crazy, but like literally it was all these memories of me and my sister and the good and the bad, and I was just trapped in a room. It wasn't good. But by asking myself these questions, I developed a routine down there. I started cleaning my cell every day after we got food, and like literally deep cleaning the cell. And afterwards, I'd feel great because I was living in a clean environment. Then I would do my workout and exercise. You know, I couldn't do much, but I'd do my push-ups, pull-ups, or not pull-ups, dips off the back of the bunk. Any type of bodyweight calisthenic movement that you could do in an 8x10 cell, I was doing. And that released natural endorphins in my body, which made me feel good about myself. And I also read and write letters and stuff. And all these things, by developing that pattern, were a result of the questions that I asked myself. If I had to ask myself, why does this gotta happen? Why do I gotta feel this way? Why is my life horrible or whatever? You know, then I would have got those results. So it's key in the moments of crisis to ask yourself empowering questions. And it's key to ask yourself empowering questions habitually, to become consciously aware of the questions that we ask ourselves and replace them with empowering questions. All right, so here are the 5 questions that you wanna ask yourself. Number 1, ask yourself, what is great about this problem? The power of that question is you're focusing on what is great about the problem. You might come up with, your first response might be nothing, you know, but then by honestly asking yourself that question with enough emotional intensity of seeking out the true answer, you might come up with, I'm learning from it, or it's making me stronger, or it's bringing me closer to my goal, or it's making me make a strategic connection with someone. Whatever the question may be, that question is very powerful. What is great about this problem? 2nd question, what is not perfect yet? That's getting you to focus on what's not perfect yet, which will help you to focus on what you can improve. That might be the next step to take. So ask yourself, what is not perfect yet about this problem? 3rd question, ask yourself, what am I willing to do to make it the way I want? What am I willing to do to make it the way I want? With this, you're focused on what you can do about the situation, what you're willing to do to improve it. 4th question, what am I no longer willing to do in order to make it the way I want? And that's focusing on what you're not gonna do anymore. It might be you, and this might lead you to the answer, because you might be doing something that is preventing you from getting whatever it is that you want. And you might be doing something that's blocking that. And by asking yourself, what am I not willing to do anymore in order to make it the way I want? And by asking yourself that, you may stop doing the one thing that's been blocking you from getting it. And the 5th question, very powerful, is how can I enjoy the process while I do what is necessary in order to get what I want? You're focusing on how can I enjoy every step of the process while doing what I need to do to get done. So you're already focusing on, I'm gonna enjoy this process no matter what I gotta do to do this. I'm gonna go through the process and do whatever is necessary to get the result that I want, and how can I enjoy it every step of the way? And that's key. If you could do that, if you can enjoy the good and the bad, or the stressful times, or the trying times, or the learning and all that stuff, that is what really empowers you and helps you live life with fulfillment. You know, we only got the moment, so we gotta enjoy every step of every piece of life, because it's a journey. And that question right there is the most powerful question you can ask yourself in this problem-solving process. And my question to you is, do you have my free goal-getter cheat sheet yet? Have you downloaded that yet? If not, that's okay. If yes, awesome. If you haven't though, I encourage you to do it right now, because this process is what I developed over the last few years that has helped me I'm a goal achievement coach. This is what I study on a day-to-day basis. This is what I dedicate my whole entire life to. And this process is what empowered me to take my life from being an ex-convict, drug addict, and completely transforming it to becoming a responsible father and a successful entrepreneur. And I want you to have this process too, because I know how powerful it is. You can download it simply by clicking right here. And after you get that process, if you know anybody that could benefit from hearing this message, share it with them. I ask you to share it with them, because the right message for the right person at the right time can make a miracle happen. You never know what the right message for the right person at the right time, what it could do. So I ask that you share it with them, and I appreciate you greatly. Keep on crushing those goals. Keep on dominating life. Make sure you hit that subscribe button and the bell notification if you haven't already. That way you don't miss anything. And thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time.